position I win. How's it make you feel? Tell me what you'd say that truly makes it real. Kings and queens, philosophers, I've tried so hard to find. Just tell me what it means to you, dear, never mind. 'Cause love is kind when the world is cold. Love stays strong when the fight gets old. Love is a shoulder to lean on, love is you. Love's like the water when the well runs dry. Quench my thirst, keep me alive. Just need one sip, baby. Love is you, oh, love is you.
Sexiest nighttime show in the city. Love and relationships. Our phone lines are open. 741-WVEE. Now here's your host, Joyce Littell, on the People Station, V103.
People Station, V103. Thanks for listening to Love and Relationships on the Quiet Storm and on News and Talk 1380 WAOK. Tonight, again, I wish all moms a happy Mother's Day. Truly hope that you had a wonderfully blessed day today. My blessings are still happening. Not only did I have a great day earlier with my family, but I am having a wonderful moment right now. You know, I've been in the game a long time, over 25 years I've been in radio. So I've seen and met quite a few artists and quite a few people. Artists that I can say, thank you, nice to meet you, keep it moving. And there are some that I have just instantly fallen in love with. And this one artist that I'm having the pleasure of introducing to you again tonight is Chrisette Michele. Someone back in 2007 or 2006 in there, when I first heard you on the scene, I'm like, oh my God, this woman's voice and her style is so unique. Do you hear that? And welcome, by the way. See, I am so into you. I'm just ready to just jump right into it. First, let me give you a little bit of background that we know of. Okay. She's described as the soulful songbird. She's a Long Island, New York native. Her debut album, I Am, was released in 2007 and blessed the industry with hits like If I Had My Way, which you just heard, and Best of Me. I can list the whole album, to me, was just fantastic. She was nominated for a BET Award for Best New Artist, as well as 2 Grammys. Ladies and gentlemen, Chrisette Michele.
Hi.
How you doing? You are so pretty.
Thank you.
Thank you for coming and taking the time out on Mother's Day to share some intimate conversations with the Love and Relationships family. And like I said earlier, if you want to talk to Chrisette Michele, call us at 741-WVEE. When did you first know that music was your destiny?
Music was always part of my life since I was a little kid. So in church, there was always an organ and a drum set. So it's never really not been a part of my life and my destiny.
Never have.
It's always been a part of my life.
You just did you know the direction in which you were going to go since like so many artists have started singing in the church? Mm-hmm. Did you know that you were going in this direction? Because your sound, like I said, is so unique. It mm-hmm. has an artistic flair about it. How did you develop that particular sound?
Well, it wasn't on purpose. My dad handed me a saxophone when I was about 8 years old. I brought home a flute, actually, and he wasn't interested in that flute. But what happened was the saxophone introduced me to jazz. I was in every jazz band, every jazz choir, every jazz, anything that I could possibly get my mind around. And so Ella Fitzgerald, Billie Holiday, Sarah Vaughan, Astrid Getzko, Birdo, Art Blakey, Bix Beiderbecke.
But you're young.
Yeah, that was what I fell in love with.
You're in your early 20s. You're young, and you're talking about music classic music that you hear your great aunt and dad and mm-hmm. mom and, you know, these people talk about that influenced your sound. That's amazing to me.
Yeah. I was always a daddy's girl. I wrote the song Your Joy on my first album, which is about my dad.
Don't let me start singing your song.
Yeah, so I always wanted to do anything that was like my dad. Mm-hmm. I wanted to be just like my dad. And so if he said, you know, how about the saxophone? I was going to practice the saxophone until dad thought it was great. And he was so proud of me, so I just kept going, and I fell in love with it myself.
So do you, have you, and I'm sorry if I'm not aware of it. So have you done any music playing, or you just focus more on the singing part of you?
Well, I thought you know, when I was younger, I used to carry my saxophone around with my book bag in school. I was very, very serious about the sax. And it meant so much to me that I was a girl playing the baritone saxophone in the fifth and sixth grade. Not many girls were able to do that at my age. So I was very, very proud of it. And yeah, I was a musician, absolutely.
You know I was on that song, right? The Best of Me. Beautiful song. Who wrote it?
Me.
What was it about? Defining the best in Chrisette Michele?
It was about, you know, a lot of the songs on the last record were about other people. So that song was about somebody who I knew who had went through a tough breakup, who's actually married and had a tough divorce. And so that was about their situation.
So other folks and yours and anything is an inspiration to your writing?
Yeah, especially on the first album. The second album is a little more personal. The first album, I was a little scared to tell folks my business.
Why?
So I told other folks. Because I had heard all of these horror stories about what happens if you talk about yourself.
Really?
Yeah. So I was nervous.
You just didn't want to put that bad seed out there first.
Yeah.
741 WVEE. If you want to check in with Chrisette Michele, now's the time to call. Like I said, we're going to play all of your stuff.
Okay.
We're playing everything. Next song we're going to play is Call Your Joy. What is that about?
My dad. On Sunday mornings, holding my dad's hand on the way to church. In a Philly red or pink dress or whatever it was. Those are some of my most vivid memories of my childhood. Just walking like my dad.
Are you an only child?
No. Actually, my mom was a foster mom, so there were many, many kids in my house all the time. But I like to say I'm a favorite of my dad.
Yeah, because
I'm his only girl.
You sing about him, you talk about him, and I mean, it just seems like you were the it. Would you
in
say
my
that?
Head. In my head. But I have two wonderful, wonderful brothers, and just,
what do they do?
My brother Lem Payne is a rapper, singer, he plays the piano, he dances, he's incredible. And then my baby brother is into graphic design, so he's really, really gifted in that area.
How supportive of that are you?
Incredibly. It breaks my heart how supportive they are. My whole family, and I have a very, very big family, is so supportive of me, and I just always want to give them as much as I can because they give me so much joy.
Beautiful song, Your Joy, about dad.
Yes.
That's a great thing. You don't hear too many people sing about their dads.
Yeah. It's interesting when I wrote this
you
song.
You didn't get any opposition about that? Because you don't hear a lot of dad songs.
Yeah. I did get quite a bit of opposition about it because when I wrote it, a lot of people said, change it to being about a mom, which we love moms, especially here on Mother's Day.
Right.
But they said because there's not enough black fathers.
But that's all the more reason to sing.
Well, and you know there are some wonderful men out there, like my dad, like your dad was.
Right.
So
and my husband to his children.
Your husband,
you know, I mean he's a great dad. So
and I hope to find one. For my kids.
I hope so too. Girl, you Chrisette Michele. It is.
I better
find. No problem.
It
shouldn't be no
tell
problem.
Tell this microphone something right now.
I know your BlackBerry over there blow up. You turning them
hi,
down.
Hi, boys.
In every city. No, baby, I gotta keep it moving. I know that's not an issue.
Oh, man.
Is an issue?
Well, we want what we want, you know?
Right.
And so.
So describe a Chrisette Michele man.
Well, the main thing is confidence and stability.
Mm-hmm.
There's so many wonderful, wonderful men who are really uncomfortable with their position in life or who just don't feel like they have enough in life, who maybe don't know how to invest their time properly and don't know where to put their things, and so they aren't stable. I think that a woman needs to feel comfortable with a man who's stable in what he's doing. So I need stability. I need confidence.
Okay.
I don't care
about
what it is that you do as long as you're excited about it.
Mm-hmm. Have a passion for it.
Yeah. And as long as it's going somewhere.
And supportive of you?
Oh, of course.
That has to be.
Of course, because I'll be supportive of you.